New chapter we are going on. Now, before we start, I want to show you a diagram. Okay. This is a raw diagram of a ship shape. And all these definitions will get linked to this. Okay. Now, this and this is similar one. I kept both because sometimes you might find this one is a little clearer than this. And this. So there is one we see from side view, and one is fore and aft view. Fore and aft means if I see from forward, I see only the width, right? I don't see the length. So here I don't see the width, and here I see no length. I see only the width. Now, ship has got different shapes. Some of them are prehistoric, they don't exist today, but you must know all of them. Means this is the terminology you have to do, what do you say, by heart, which is your favorite strength, isn't it? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
I know, it is not something good, like we don't like to do anything by heart. So, now why these so many different dimensions are there? What happened is, shipping is fairly old business. And the ports were surviving on some sort of a collection of money from the ships. So, over the years, there have been rules how much ships should pay. Because, after all, ship owners are going to argue, my ship is small, why should I pay same amount like other one? Like same arguments you see in cooperative societies. I live in one bedroom flat, how can I pay extra? So somebody says, no, it should be same for everybody. Then I will say, no, but you live in three bedroom. So that is why there are certain rules. Now, they all rules have got something to do with what we are going to study today. These dimensions are measured in a particular way because they are connected with dues. Okay, your gross tonnage is so much, you pay so much. Like that. So, they are clearly defined because there have been many arguments over this. So, everything is quite clearly defined. Maybe complex because, again, this is this and this is that and some complex issues will be there. Those are the all dimensions why they are like that. You need to know most of the definitions very thoroughly, means by heart. Especially, I have marked the asterisk. You can see this asterisk here. Yes? No? Can you see this asterisk?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, okay, good. Now, you know the ship is always floating in water, correct? So, there is a separation of underwater volume and on top volume, correct? Somewhere where there is a water line. That is water line. Where you say that this is under and this is above. Where I draw it, it is the water line. Rudder post is situated near aft end of the ship. Rudder post is always near aft end of the ship because that is the last part of the ship which is controlled. It is behind the propeller. Summer load line means what this is commonly used everywhere is summer load line. Summer load line is a water line at summer draft. That means when the ship is loaded to the summer draft, the water line what is there, that is summer load line. Bow or stem, both words are used to refer to the forward part of the ship. Bow or stem. Both have got same meaning. Bow or stem is the forward part of the ship. Keel is the bottom of the ship. Keel is the flat bottom of the ship. Deck means flooring of the ship. Okay. The floor is called deck. Draft means the depth of the ship below waterline, that is draft. Means whatever is below. Every time you will not be at summer load line, ship will have different drafts at different times. So what is draft? This is the depth below the waterline. That means I need more water than this to float. Clear up to this? Yes, no? Sir. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, after perpendicular means what? A perpendicular drawn to the water line at the point where the after side of the rudder post meets the summer load line. And where there is no rudder post, then it is taken center of the rudder stock. These parts you will be doing later on in construction, but you have to just remember this much. This first part of the line, rudder post meets the summer load line. Summer load line, okay? Here. See, this is after perpendicular. This vertical line is after perpendicular. Here also it is defined here. See the after part of the rudder post. Just behind the rudder post is after perpendicular. Okay? Got idea? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Forward perpendicular is the perpendicular drawn to the water line at the point where the fore and aft of the stem, forward side of the stem meets summer load line. Means forward part. Now we saw the after perpendicular, the forward one. Forward is, see, this is summer load line. Okay. So this is water level. Where this ship's end touches, that is my forward perpendicular. Here also, see, this is the summer draft. So where this forward end meets, that is the forward perpendicular. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we have got next one is length between perpendiculars. This is a very simple one. The length between forward and aft perpendicular measured along the summer load line. Like here you have got LBP here. Okay. See this. This one was the after perpendicular. And this is the forward perpendicular. So this length is called length between perpendiculars. LBP. Okay, here also again you see length between perpendiculars because there are two perpendiculars we have drawn. Okay? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, I know this is little boring, this is like mugging up, but these are important ones. Amidship. A point midway between after and forward perpendiculars, that means the half of LBP. Right, amidship means this point amidships is 50% here, 50% here, measured along the length of the summer load line between the forward and aft perpendicular. Correct, that is amidships. Clear,
sir. Amidship, I mean, the half of the LBP doesn't mean half of the ship.
No, it is not half of the ship, it is between forward and aft perpendicular. Some
no,
ship,
I wanted to know if it coincides.
See, what happened? No, it will not coincide because sometimes this bow may be like this. Bigger. The flare will be bigger. It is possible. Or the stern will be extended stern. Possible. So you can't say it's the same point. This amidship is between the two perpendicular. Not half of length overall. We are coming to length overall now. Got clear clarity?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next one is length overall. Length overall means total length. Absolutely forward to aft. Means the foremost point to the aftermost point. It is length overall. Now see, the length overall has got nothing to do with summer load line. It has got nothing to do with what is underwater. Got it? Extremities.
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose in this case or this case, suppose if this bulbous bow was more, then you will measure from here. 1 minute, let me just take one. Hello. हाँ बोला. हाँ मी फोन केलेला तेच माझं काल मी फ्लोरा सिटी मधून बोलत होता ना दामले ते तुम्ही पाठवलंय मला नाही मला मिळालं नाही. हाँ हाँ ठीक आहे चालेल. ओके राईट थँक्यू. Okay, sorry. What happened is there is a confusion going on Blue Dart. So my ATM card, it's supposed to be debit card, was supposed to be coming here, and guy gave bullshit that nobody allowed him to come in. Okay. So all extremities, that is length overall, means suppose for some reason, if this bow had to be longer than the stem here, then you will measure from here to the another end. That is the maximum length you need to birth safely. That is length overall. Plus you need some extra distance to make sure that two ships are not touching each other. Lloyd's length. Now these are unimportant ones. Okay. Now the terminology here, scantlings. Scantlings is the framing and all. That is called scantling. Okay. It is more or less same length perpendicular, but it should not be less than 96% and all. This is all something to do with the dues and all. Okay. But just you know, there is something called Lloyd's length, there is something called registered length, and there is also something called IMO length. These are the different ways of measuring ship's length. Now see, what is important is length overall, because this is, we know, our physical limitation. Length between perpendiculars is more about, I will say, length between perpendicular has got more to do with the taxes and markings of the ships and all. Amidship comes from there. Now what is amidship? Amidship, you also have got draft markings as well as you have got the load line markings amidships. So that is where we decide which is the center point. Now, best way to decide, they have decided between the perpendiculars. Molded dimensions means, this is something, this part you have to understand very, very clearly. What used to happen is, earlier days, the ship was made with the frames first, wooden ships. And then the wooden planks were put from outside. Now, obviously, when you put the plank from outside, the width will increase, no? If this is my frame and I put something from here, let's say, something from here. Now my width has increased by this much. This is my width increase. So, molded dimensions were, the mold was there. Mold was the framing. So, measurements of the framing is molded dimension. Now, that means if you are deciding like today's ship, okay, it is more complex. That means you take inside the plating of a ship, not extremes. That means, again, I am repeating, this is my, okay, I'll put it this way. This is my frame. And if I add up this plate from outside, I add the thickness, maybe 20 millimeters extra here and other side 20 millimeters extra So the molded dimensions are the basically frame dimensions. So they are inside of the plating of a ship, like it happens with the hull also. Baseline, we'll come to that baseline. Okay, so you got the molded dimensions, clear or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so molded width will be always less than maximum width. Okay, always remember, molded dimensions will be little less than the physical dimensions if you take from extreme ends. Okay, baseline is a horizontal line drawn at the top of the keel plate. See, why top of the keel plate? Because the molded dimensions are there. All vertical molded dimensions are measured from this line. Now, let us see the line. See, here, this is baseline, but baseline is, if this is my keel plate, I don't measure from here. This is my baseline. Baseline is above keel plate. This point is called baseline, not this thickness added up. Got it? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Got it, no? Okay, this is very careful thing for molded and what is the physical. Molded breadth means measure at midship section. That is where ship is at fattest dimension. Okay. But again, it's measured from inside of the plating. So, molded breadth will always be less than the extreme breadth. Extreme breadth is the physical dimension end to end. How much size do I need? Or another way I can show you is, let me see something. Sorry, I could not find something more suitable. Now, if this is the ship, the molded dimensions means from inside I take, inside to inside. Extreme means from outside to outside. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear now?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So, molded draft is from baseline to the summer load line. Baseline to the summer load line at the midship section. See, that is where all this amidship is coming in. All where midship sections. That is where the ship is the broadest. So, draft is to summer line. Whatever it is up to summer line. Molded depth is baseline to the heel of the upper deck beam. Means, suppose if this is the way, okay, this is the ship, if this is the summer load line. So when I measure from here to the bottom is my molded draft. Molded depth is my full depth, but under the top frame, heel of the upper deck beam. Okay, top frame underneath to the baseline. Extreme beam. See, again we have seen what the breadth, draft, depth. Correct? Now, extreme beam means breadth. Extreme breadth means from outside. Outside to outside. Extreme draft lowest point of keel to the summer load line. Means instead of taking, like I told you, from inside of the base plate, baseline, now we are taking from the bottom. That is extreme draft to summer load line. Draft, when you say, it is summer load line. Extreme depth is from there to the upper deck. Okay, at amidship. Upper deck to the lowest point, that is extreme. Means those are the physical dimensions if you measure with it. Half breadth, it is generally what happens, instead of showing cross section of a ship like this, they show only half. Other is symmetrical, so you get only half of it. And that half breadth is for this, that is what is used. Both sides are symmetrical on a ship. You will never have one side bigger than other. Freeboard. Freeboard is between vertical distance, okay, at amidships, between summer load line and the freeboard deck. Now, freeboard deck is normally uppermost deck. Normally, the uppermost deck is the freeboard deck. But how will you measure it? So, okay, so we have a marking. Okay, let me finish this part first. Okay. Exposed to weather, there are permanent winds of closing, all openings, etc. So, it is the uppermost deck which is completely sealed, in simple words. But it is more difficult to measure from there, so we have got something called deck line. This line is calculated, this is the most important horizontal line mark. Because from there, everything will be measured. So, deck line is the horizontal line mark amidships. Again, amidship has come. On each side of the ship, both the sides, that means, okay? Okay, it normally pass through point. This is not possible because most of the ships, it is not possible to put deck line on that level. So, what happens is, you put it in one position and then you make the allowance for that. Means, instead of putting, say, on 0, I put it at 1 and I always say that 1 is to be added up. You don't do any addition because this is done by classification society and they mark that first. This is the position. After that, you refer everything from that line. So, everything is taken care of. We don't get involved in why it is in particular location. It is put amidship. Always remember it is amidship. That is between LBP, halfway point between forward and aft, perpendicular. From here, the freeboards are measured. Okay. Now, this is not like, you know, this is ideally what it should be, this one, ideally. However, all the ships you will find it is position is decided by the authority. That is, one reference point is given. From that reference point, everything else will be drawn for load lines. So, that is why it is very important line on ship is the deck line. From there, we measure the freeboard, what is allowed. And this line is fixed, marked, and is not changed during the life of the ship. Deck line is 300 millimeters long, 25 millimeters in width. But it is never changed. And how it is marked? Not by punching, it is welded. It is embossed, it is welded on that, and from there everything starts about, all our rest of the things will start for load line. Now here are some of the dimensions when we see, okay, because here what happens is, depth is there, this is the depth, this is the draft summer load line to the bottom maximum, and the molded draft will be from baseline to this. Then you don't have freeboard marked here because freeboard is this part is freeboard from sorry this part is freeboard. Here it is marked summer load line to the deck line is summer freeboard. Then there are more things which we'll be doing, but remember they are always marked amidships. Shear is what happens is instead of having straight deck, it rises up like this. Okay, like this. I mean, this is flat and this is going up. This is shear. And this is shear and all, you have to know it. On ships, it is designed, so there is nothing you can do except you know okay, that is shear. Camber is, decks are not flat like this. The main deck is not flat. It is slightly curved to allow water to get out quickly. So that is camber. Curvature. Transverse direction, measure height of above. Because this is, you get definitions as a question. This is camber, see. If it is straight, it will be here, but it is raised to allow water to drain out faster. That is camber. And these definitions are generally about 10 marks on this. Rise of floor. Now it actually doesn't happen, but it is said it is there, so it is there, but it doesn't happen anymore. This is exaggerated anyway. That ship is shaped like this. Now this is rise of floor. This. See here it is shown. Rise of floor. This angle is rise of floor. Maybe in millimeters or something, but it doesn't exist on modern ships. Half siding of the keel means you talk on the half part. And the other one is, the other side is the same. And normally what happens is when you are going to dry it off, they have to put the blocks there. So it comes handy that time. Tumble home. It used to happen on older ship. It is not there on a modern ship. Tumble home means, this is tumble home. This is curved inside instead of straight line. It used to get curved inside. Older ships, no passenger ships, you can notice it. If you see pictures, and this deviation is tumble home. These are favorite questions for those 10 marks. Flare, outward curvature of the hull. Okay, means the bow, instead of you don't make a straight bow, no, you open it up like this. So this is flare. Stem wreck is inclination of stem line from the vertical. Now these are all things here. This is the flare. Stem wreck, it's forward shear is there. Stem wreck is not measured here somehow. Okay. Stem line from the vertical. Inclination of stem line from the vertical. Then keel rake, inclination of steel line from the horizontal. Now trawlers and all they have got, like, you know, the keel rake is this part, it goes up like this. You know, if it is cut like this, then it is keel rake. That shear you saw and the rake is okay. Then you have got twin deck height. Now twin deck height is something that is cargo ship. From base you will have twin deck at some height, so that is not important one, so don't worry. Parallel middle body, like I told you, the ship is a box in the middle and then you attach. So parallel middle body is length where the sides remain parallel. You measure it on the, actually it is more reference term, but you check it on the water line. Below water line, shape can start changing. It is a three dimensional. So you just see the parallel middle body. Now when the parallel middle body meets the forward part, it is called entrance. That point is called entrance. That means either my third one is not given. The entrance will be somewhere here. It is to be put on. I think I need to put one more diagram here. I'll put one more diagram here. Okay, because that is the shape is like this, no? Shape is like this and then like this. So this shape, see, this curved part, when it meets the straight line, this part is called entrance. And similarly, astern, when the curved part starts, that is called run. But ship behind, you know, the parallel sides. Tonnage. Now here it is a lot of confusion on the word tonnage. Tonnage means this is the sort of a cubic volume of the ship. Okay. Internal volume, and two types it is measured. It is measured in two types. One is gross tonnage, one is net tonnage, and then there is international tonnage. Because every country had different ideas of calculating it. See, the tonnage is very important because all your charges, dues, are based on tonnage. So, gross tonnage and net tonnage. So, it is the cubic capacity of the volume of the ship which is usable. One is a gross one. That is, this is the full volume. This is the, means one way or the other, it is the volume of the ship. Internal volume. Huh? Then comes net tonnage. Net tonnage means generally it is related to where you can earn money. Some part is you cannot earn money. It is there, is there. That's it. So that is gross is full, net is less, and that is the earning capacity more or less. It is linked with earning. But it is complex calculation with logarithms and all. It is not something you are given figure. Now every country used to have own ideas of measuring it. Oh, we don't count this, we count this. So, in the end, we got international tonnage. Now, everybody accepts international tonnage. There is a certificate which says this is international tonnage, gross tonnage so much, and net tonnage so much. Now, mistakenly, we do use the terms like GRT and NRT, which is technically wrong. There is nothing called gross registered tonnage or net registered tonnage. The registered word has gone. What we have is gross tonnage, net tonnage. It is generally, originally it was computed cubic feet per ton. Per ton means it is a ton or a century. Like we say in cricket, he hit a ton. Ton means he hit a century. Double ton means to double hundred. So the ton is 100. Ton is not weight. Do not make this mistake anytime. Some big thing had made a mistake earlier. I had noticed it actually long back. The customs had made this mistake while calculating dues of the ships. Tonnage. The people get confused, so don't make this particular mistake anytime. Deadweight is loading capacity of the ship. That is deadweight. So when we compare deadweight, means we are comparing the capacities. Then you have got air draft. Air draft is from the surface of the water to the highest point of the ship, which will be generally one of the masts. That is highest point of the ship. Generally, again, remember I use word generally, because on ro-ro ships it happens sometimes that the ram is higher than the mast. It happens. So that is why I use term generally. So then the highest part to the water level, and you need to know this air draft, because if you are going under a bridge or under a power cable or something, you must know that your ship can go through without breaking anything. Bilge radius is the radius of the rounded that is here. This is bilge radius here. Okay. You can see it? Yes, no. Can you see? Or should I make it? This is radius. Bilge radius here. This curvature. Got it or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because this is mugging up, you know, everywhere you'll find the same stuff. Actually, bilge radius is what we say, na? The rounded portion has got a curvature where the keel plating meets the side plating. That point is the bilge curvature. Now, this chapter is finished. And